in the last video, Company A took out a $1 million loan from Lender 1 at a variable interest rate, and Company B took out a fixed rate $1 million loan from Lender 2. And then they entered into this swap agreement where Company A pays a fixed 7% every period, 7% on a notional $1 million, notional meaning that the $1 million doesn't exchange hands, only the interest does. A pays a 7% on that notional $1 million every period to B. B pays LIBOR plus 1% on that notional $1 million every period to A. So it pays a variable rate on that notional amount. And what I want to do in this video is go through the numerical mechanics to show that, in effect, Company A now has a fixed rate loan, when you think of it from the point of view of the interest it's paying, and Company B now has a variable rate loan. They've kind of swapped the fixed and variable natures of their loans. So let's think about what happens in Company A in period one. So in the old period one, it had to pay $70,000 of interest to the lender. So it had to pay, so I'll say, let me write it this way. So it had to, let me give myself some room here. So in period one, Company A had to pay $70,000 to Lender 1. But now, that's not all it has to do. It definitely still has to do that. This loan is still in effect. But now it also has to pay seven percent fixed to be on that notional million. So it also has to pay $70,000, 7% on a million, to Company B. But in exchange for that, it's going to get LIBOR plus 1% from B. So it's going to get LIBOR, we're assuming, is at 5% in period one. 5% plus 1% is 6%. 6% on a notional $1 million is $60,000. So 60K from 60K from B. So net, it pays 70 twice, but then it gets back 60. So it's paying $80,000. So the net is paying $80,000. Now let's think about what happens in period two when LIBOR changes. So in period two now, LIBOR changed to 4%. And so A would have to pay 4% plus the 2% on its loan, which is 6% or $60,000. It would have to pay $60,000 to its lender. It would have to pay B the $70,000 still. It would pay $70,000 to B. But in exchange, it would get LIBOR plus 1% from B. So LIBOR is at 4%. 4% plus 1% is 5%. It would get $50,000. So it would get $50,000 in that period from B. So what's the total amount that it paid? So it pays 60 plus 70, which is 130,000, but then it gets back 50,000 from the swap agreement. So it pays $80,000. It's now paying $80,000. And notice, that doesn't change from any period. I encourage you to try out changing the actual LIBOR rate, and you'll see that it does not change the amount that A pays. A is now, in effect, paying a fixed rate. Now, the opposite is going to happen with B. In the old one, every period it paid $80,000, but now it's going to be a little bit different. In period one, it still pays $80,000, and we could write that in every period. Period two, it still pays $80,000, and then it's going to get 7% every period from Company A. So it will get $70,000. But now it's going to be paying LIBOR plus 1%. So in period one, it's going to pay $60,000. And then in period two, it's going to pay $50,000. So net, you pay 50, you get 70, so that's a pot of, you're still paying 10, and then you pay another 60. So that your net is, you're going to pay 70K in period one, and then in period two, you're going to pay, what does that come out to? You're going to pay 60K. So now all of a sudden, Company A is paying a fixed 8% every period, and Company B is going to pay, essentially, is a variable rate.